Okay, in this next video on bonds, what I'd like to do is go through the different types of bond issuers. Who issues and sell bonds? And then I'd like to go through the risk premium, because some bonds pay more than others, and how that affects the yields on these bonds. Okay, types of bond issuers. Corporations, they issue bonds. It's cheaper than borrowing money from a bank. So if Apple needs a few billion, well, they probably don't, but if GM needs a few billion to buy cars, if Boeing needs a few billion to develop a new airplane, they might issue bonds, and these are called corporate bonds. And remember, it's not the same as issuing stock. Stock is ownership in the company. Bonds are just borrowing money, lending money to the company. Now, some companies' bonds are riskier than others. And you may not want to buy the most risky ones, unless they're paying a higher interest rate. But before you buy a bond from Boeing or Microsoft or Apple, you'd want to know something about what is your risk here, that they're not going to pay the money back, that they're going to default when that date of maturity comes and not pay back the principal or the whole principal. So there's companies that rate these bonds. They look at the company and their assets, figure out what the chances are of them going broke and not paying the money back, and they rate them. And all the ratings are a little bit different from company to company, but it generally looks something like this. The best quality companies have their bonds rated AAA. A little bit less than that is AA. A little lower than that is A. So A sounds pretty good, but it's not the best. And they might also put a few other things down here, like a, you know, A plus or A plus plus on the bonds too. Something kind of different between A and AA. Then below that are the B bonds, which usually like triple B. And then under that, double B. And under that, a B. So B doesn't sound too bad, but it's like at least 6 or 8 notches down. Then we get into the C's. By the time we get into the C's, these bonds are riskier. And they're referred to in this area. I'm not sure exactly where the line is between them, but when we get down in this area, they're called junk bonds. Now, I mean, they're not junk. It just means the chances of them defaulting and not paying back the principal are higher. These are sometimes referred to as high yield bonds. Because the interest rate that you can earn on them is higher. The yield is higher. You have to be compensated for that extra risk. Then there's municipal bonds. These are bonds issued by cities. Maybe they need to build a new school system, so they put a vote up to their voters about borrowing money, issuing some bonds to borrow the money to build the schools. Then they pay back that money to those bondholders for the next 20, 30 years, something like that. So these are cities. They can default too. Sometimes cities default and they don't pay the money back. So there's some risk to municipal bonds. And there's government bonds. Pretty much all governments need to borrow money from time to time. These are also referred to as sovereign bonds. S-O-V-E-R-N, E-R-E-I-G-N, because they're issued by sovereign countries. Sometimes governments default on their bonds and don't pay it back. One of the biggest defaults in history was Argentina. About 2001, they defaulted on $100 billion of their debt, of their bonds. Debt is bonds because they've borrowed money. Puerto Rico is defaulted. Russia is defaulted. Greece is defaulted. The U.S. has never defaulted on their bonds. So one type of government, the U.S. government bond, has never defaulted. And because of that, we can say that it's risk-free. The U.S. government bonds are risk-free. Not because you can't lose money on them. You can lose money on them, and I'll show you in another video how you can lose money on them. They're considered risk-free AAA because there's no risk of default. The U.S. government will always pay that money back. They've got the printing presses. If nothing else, they can always fire up the printing presses, print the money, and pay people back for those bonds on the date of maturity. Now, the official names of the U.S. government securities, and securities is just another name for bonds. So if you hear the term for securities, they may be talking about stocks, they might be talking about bonds, it's just one type of security. But the government bonds have some special names. They're issued by the Treasury. And so if the date to maturity is less than or equal to 1 year away, so the term is 1 year or less, those are known as T-bills. T stands for Treasury bills. If it's equal to 30 years, because the Treasury does make a 30-year bond, those are called T-bonds or Treasury bonds. Anything else in the middle is called a T-note, Treasury note. And that's for bonds that have a greater than 1 year term and less than 30-year term. I may not always give them their exact name. I usually will just call them all bonds. And this is what I mean by them. Now, the yield on the bond, remember, is the interest rate that the purchaser earns. So it's the interest rate the purchaser, or really the lender, will earn. Usually expressed as an annual rate, like 3% a year or 10% a year, something like that. So in our formula where we had present value times 1 plus I equals the future value, this is the yield right here. The interest rate that the bond is earning is the yield on the bond. Now, some bonds pay more than others. Remember, riskier bonds tend to pay more because people don't want them as much if they are rated junk. So the demand for is less on them, present value is less, and the interest rate is a little bit higher. We can calculate what that risk premium is. So the yield on a bond is equal to what the yield would be if there was no risk of default, plus some risk premium. So I say it's equal to the risk-free rate. the interest rate it would be if there was no risk of default plus some sort of risk premium. The additional interest that has to be earned because there's some risk associated with it. So let's say we looked at, say, the 10-year, same example, the 10-year GM bond, General Motors bond. So the 10-year GM bond. So GM is the issuer. And if you go buy one of their bonds, maybe from somebody else that bought it from them years ago when they issued them, let's say the interest rate, the yield that you could earn is 5% on that bond. Well, what's the risk premium? Well, that's whatever we earn up and over the risk-free rate. The extra interest we get because GM could go bankrupt. After all, they have gone bankrupt in the past. Where could we get a measure of the risk-free rate? The interest rate if there was no chance of default. Well, that's the interest rate on the US government bond. So we're gonna get the interest rate on the 10-year US government bond. So the interest on the 10-year US government bond, which would be a T-note, let's say that fluctuates all the time. Let's say it's 0.5%. That means the government's going to give you 0.5% interest on your money every year for 10 years. So the risk-free rate is 0.5%. That means the risk premium would be 4.5%. So you'd get an extra 4.5% interest on your money by buying these GM bonds because of the risk premium. We get an extra 4.5% yield on the bond because of the 4.5% for the risk premium. Okay, so in this video, we went through the types of bond issuers, the corporate bond, where the corporations, cities, governments. And the risk-free rate is the interest rate that you can earn on US government bonds because they're considered risk-free. Bonds are rated, lots of different ways of rating, but they're kind of similar. AAA is on the top. And that means AAA has the least chance of going bankrupt and not paying your money back. The least chance of default. As we go down the list, there's a greater chance of default. And those bonds are going to have to pay a higher interest rate. They will pay a higher interest rate because there's some risk premium. There's some risk to those bonds.